Your house?
We're here now. Can we just talk?
We couldn't go nowhere else. We just got a hotel.
Can we just talk?
Alright, well.
Remember a couple of weeks ago you said that you wanted us to be honest with each other?
Yeah, I remember that conversation. We was at a restaurant or something. Hmm. Yeah, I remember that. Yeah, I remember that. Why?
Well, how do you feel about me?
Huh?
How do you feel about me?
I love you. I told you that before.
Why do you love me?
You know why I love you. Come
no,
on.
I don't. That's why I'm
asking. Because I love you, okay? You just... What are we here for? Just... Okay.
Is there anything you want to tell me?
No, I don't think so. We know everything about each other, so you don't really have to.
Well, do you want to take this relationship to another level?
That's the plan.
What does that mean to you?
You know, like years and future and things.
I'm serious.
Yes, I want to take it to the next level. Yes. We're at a high level now, aren't we?
Could you see me in your future?
Yes.
Your far future?
Far. Very far. Why are we talking about the future anyway? I mean, you're
probably... Because I'm pregnant.
Huh? Huh?
I'm for real.
Wait a minute. We use the card of every single time. Wait. Yeah, we use the condom. I mean,
it's not 100%.
But it's 97%. Whatever. It's very.
I'm for real. I'm pregnant.
I'm gonna ask this. Don't get mad at me. You know, it was a classic question.
You know that I've only been with you. Don't even go there with me.
I just had to get that out the way. Okay. You go. You take the test and you go.
I'm not killing nothing.
I'm not saying that, I'm just saying...
Well, what are you saying? I'm telling you I'm pregnant. What do you want to do about it?
Oh. Alright, okay, yeah.
I'm not getting rid of it.
Alright, okay. You don't have to get rid
of it. You said you love me.
Yes, I do.
You have love for me and
yeah,
only
and
me?
We're gonna work it out. You got the baby. Yeah, we're gonna work it out.
We're gonna get a place together? You don't let me come to yours.
Because my place, you know, was going on a lot of construction and stuff.
Don't you think we've been together for a while?
Yeah, but...
For me not to been at your place?
But
ever?
If you...
Ever?
It's really not...
Ever?
The place you want to be. But let's not talk about that, because we got a baby to worry about the future. You talk about the future, let's not worry about the past. That's not... The future, okay? We going to try to get a house, maybe. You know?
Why don't you go answer the door?
Answer the door? At a hotel?
Yeah, go answer the door.
What is going on? I come here, we come to talk, and you ordering food
baby,
this time of night?
Baby, just go get the door for me, okay?
Okay, this don't feel right, you know? It's like, hotel, you got a baby.
We have a baby.
We got a baby, and you want to...
I'm going to do it by myself.
All right, you're right. Yeah, you're right about that. All right.
Is that one of your rendezvous? I'm going to the store. I'll be right back. Give me 10 minutes.
It's in your rendezvous.
boat is not a rendezvous, so...
Surprise, surprise.
How did you end up in a hotel?
I just told you I was going to go see your friend.
A friend? Is that what I am?
I've never met this friend before.
You don't mean to lie about my friend.
But what? No. I'm not your girlfriend?
Girlfriend?
I'm not your pregnant girlfriend? I'm not your grow old with girlfriend. I'm not your girlfriend who just said I love you in there. Who you want to spend the rest of your life with, girlfriend?
The rest of your life?
Wow. How did this happen?
You need to get to talking because you don't have no words. I don't understand.
Oh, I just need to sit down for a second. I just come on. The room is spinning right now.
You're pathetic is what you are.
Okay, listen, how do you two know? You just got here, like...
You're a dumbass, basically. You left my number in her phone.
This is who you was talking about?
For how long did you think it was gonna last before
I didn't think it was gonna last.
You have a baby to deal with now, so what are you gonna do?
A baby?
Ooh, so that means you got two.
Child support.
No, you don't want... Listen, okay. I was watching the show, and
I thought you loved me. I don't understand. I really don't understand.
We got a baby.
Yeah. No, listen. I really don't understand. I'm gonna need for you to explain some shit.
Okay, I'm gonna explain it right now. Listen.
Yeah.
You was wanting to get a home. Already got a home. And we gotta do something. You know?
You're not making any sense right now.
I'm trying to make some sense.
But you're not.
I want to just say right now, I'm going to take this time what we...
To say you're pathetic.
And you're a loser.
That too, but I apologize.
No, you only apologize because you got caught. You were going to keep this going for as long as you could keep it up, I guess.
You think so?
Yeah, I think so.
Listen, when you say you had a baby... You know, I slow blow, didn't know that was coming.
So, did you use protection?
Of course, I use protection all the time.
Then how does she get pregnant?
Wow, how? Just, you know, those things are not really 100%.
Cynthia, we use the condom.
Not 100%.
But it's 97%, whatever.
Sure.
Why the hell would you even do it?
Listen, all right, we just gonna calm down. All right, what's done is done, you gotta be.
What's done is I'm not pregnant. And I wouldn't have your baby if you were the last man on earth.
You mean you're not pregnant? And why would you not? You set me up?
Is this how you set us up for 2 years.
Basically.
That's what you did.
So now payback?
No. We got a house, so we got a baby.
You know what?
Hold up, now.
You know what?
Okay.
I really don't want to hear it.
You know what? Forget her. Okay? We got no strings attached.
No. Forget you.
No. We got a kid, okay? And we got to work this out to the fullest, okay? I apologize for what we got.
Mm-hmm.
Now, since she's out of my life, she's out of our life. We can continue.
Oh, really?
I will never do this again.
No. There will never be a next time.
What do you mean there'll never be a next time?
Because it won't.
Okay, look. Can I start?
No.
Can I just explain to you what I'm going to do? I want to explain to you what I'm going to do to fix all this.
We'll start explaining.
Okay, I'm going to start by saying that...
Color is emotion. It is the expression... and foundation, love, hate, rage, sadness, happiness. A red rose means I love you. A yellow rose means friendship. And white means purity. Blue, it's a baby boy. Pink, it's a baby girl. Color defines the very essence of life. Stop. Go. Yield. And now in order to live, we go green. We live in color. If the world were black and white, you would never be red with rage, green with envy, or blue with sadness. Our emotions would be nothing more than words, nothing more than a blank page, nothing more than a pitch black room, nothing. Just like in relationships, color is where things get complicated. Things should be black and white, up or down, right or wrong, on or off, in or out. Simple.
This is ridiculous.
Our emotions create those colorful moments that define who we are, who we are not, and who we will be.
Now if you darker, you light, Arab, Indian, or white, the character of a person goes so much deeper than sight. Abi Umi, why you teaching me hate?
You know what I'm saying? Put your hands in the air.
I did not see your color until you showed me the way. Hey! There's a war going on inside, everybody mind. Is it the devil who defined that dividing line? You keep feeding me the fuel, cause when you had a confidence in knowing who you are, who created you, there is nothing in this world that you can't do. And no human on this earth you got an answer to. And no person on this planet you're not equal to. Don't ever let them tell you different cause it ain't true.
Wake up.
I didn't think you would call.
I didn't think you would pick up.
So you're in Vegas?
Yeah, I'm here. You home?
Yeah. What made you call me?
Left my charger. Took me a few days to get a new one. The right one. Called you the first chance I got. Look, you know, I'm not good with apologies. I just want you to know that I didn't mean the things to get out of hand. Things just happened.
How long are we gonna be here?
I don't know. I don't know what's wrong with the car, so how am I supposed to know how long we're gonna be here?
Well, maybe you should know these things.
I'm a fucking genius now.
Well, you know Einstein to me. What?
I'm asking you what? You come out here what? I don't know what's wrong with the car, okay? So I don't know how long we're going
to
be here.
Well, I just wanted to know how long we were going to be here. I actually left something behind to come here, so I don't have time to
wait. I told you you didn't have to come if you didn't want to. If you had something to do, you could have stayed. I told you that. Don't be trying to guilt trip me with your shit, man.
Guilt trip. You want to talk about guilt trip? Why are we going to Vegas? What's in Vegas, Drew? I know you hear me. You know what? Is there any more water? Because it seems like we're going to be here for a while.
It's in the car.
Are you going to get it?
Hold your legs.
You're closer.
What's on that side?
Like us?
That's not what I meant. What I'm trying to say, look, we both screwed up, all right? We don't see things the same way. You always said we were two very different people. Looking back at it, you were right all along.
Drew, what? I tried. I really, really tried. And I pray to understand you. I don't get you sometimes. Why are you so selfish?
How the fuck am I selfish? You don't, what bills you pay? Huh? You don't pay no bills. You got a nice little apartment. Anytime you need to fly somewhere for your auditions and shit, for your modeling or whatever, you know what I'm saying? I got you. So how's that selfish? When I'm finished, I'll put it out.
I can't take this.
Take what, man? Take what?
I can't take the cigarette smoke right now. Can you talk to me without the cigarette
no.
smoke?
No. I'm trying to calm down. Can I calm down?
Am I annoying you? You need to smoke?
Not you, the car. I'm pissed off about the car. I'm not pissed off about you. Yet.
Yet? It's not that we're just two different people. It's simply the fact that you choose to do things that are only going to get you killed. I'm waiting. There's a lot more you could have done for me that you haven't done.
Like what? I'm here. You want to vent? Let's go here. Let me hear.
How are we going to build a family like this? This life?
You're a mom, right? Starting a family ain't the smartest thing to do for a modeling career, is it? You out 9 months per kid. That ain't a big out. That's not going to work.
Now you care, Drew.
Here you go.
Now
here
you care about my modeling
go.
Career.
Here you go. Come on. Want to talk? I'm talking. Now you're going to chop me up for talking. Make up your mind. Make up your mind, man.
What's noise?
It's the car. Hey, no. Stay right there. Don't move. Don't move.
Hey, look here. I'm not going to keep going back and forth with you. We've argued about this almost every day. Damn. Well, we just disagree, all right? So let's just...
So it's okay to transport a guy to Vegas in your trunk?
Hey! All right? You better... Yes, I...
Or maybe get phone calls in the middle of the night, leave and come back home with blood on your shirt. Or it's fine to come home with bruises and scars on your face. And yeah, don't get me wrong. You have taken care of me. But Drew, when are you going to start looking out for yourself? You're just a muscle man for the people you call friends.
Hey, they my family. Always will be.
Well, I hope your family looks out for your best interests. Because I've done the best I could. You were what I thought I needed in my life. But I realized over time, you were what I wanted. And my wants are just that, temporary.
You know you will always have my heart. Gave it to you a long time ago, but I do pray for your career to be marvelous, just like you.
Thank you.
Let me ask you a question.
Sure.
You decide to walk away right then? Or had you been waiting for the time to just do you?
Like you said, things happen.
Maya. Let me explain, baby. I'm just taking the dude to Vegas, okay? That's all right. Where you gonna go? We in the middle of freaking nowhere. Where you going?
Does it matter?
Come on, don't do this shit. Where the fuck is you gonna go? Let's just get this car fixed and we can go, okay? We get there, it all be squash, all right?
No, Drew.
Come on, man, don't. Where the hell is you gonna go? Where you going?
Check out?
Of course I have to pull over. If I don't, we're gonna get even more lost.
Okay, well, let's see. Let's see what the machine says. I'll do a little GPS.
Oh,
yeah, okay, let me see. Let me take a look. We'll fix it. Let's see. I don't think we're really lost. We'll find out. Let's take a look. Boy, I'll be all right. Oh, wrong way. No problem. I love how it does that. Just like Iron Man movie.
You know what that says?
What was that saying?
Lost.
Lost? No, we're not. We're not lost.
We are so lost.
Let's see. There's a river. There's this place. There's that place right over there. This place over here.
Are we going to the River Harrow?
No, we're not going to the river. But the place you said was near the river, right? Somewhere in the vicinity thereof, right? Or am I wrong?
You're wrong.
I'm wrong. I'm going to go back to the gas station. Which
this
one?
This time we're going to stop.
We're going to... Okay, you want to stop? You want me to go inside, right? Right?
How'd you know that?
I don't know. I'm just a psychic. I don't know. Just psychic.
No, I want you to go inside. This is a challenge. This is something you have to get over because...
Because men don't like to ask for directions, right?
Wow.
Yeah, exactly. I'm psychic today. I'm telling you.
You're going in by yourself.
I'm going in by... Also, I'm going to get a map then and get directions, get all that stuff, get all that good stuff, right? Look like a fool. That's all right. No problem.
Well, I'll close this because we don't need to show them that we're both fools. You go by yourself. It's solo.
Right, solo.
Right. Like I wanted to go anyway, so... I'm glad I'm making it.
What did you say?
I said my neck hurts. It hurts a little bit over here.
I heard you.
Stretching.
Like I wanted to go anyway. Nobody put a gun to your head to make you get in the car. Look at you. You're sitting over there all comfy.
All right. I'll be the good husband and get you the information. Get the guy to fill out some information for us. Directions too. Right?
Yeah.
Right?
Point to point so we can get to this retreat.
Get to this retreat? Okay. Retreat. Yeah. Something about that.
What about it?
Well, you know, to be straight up with you, wasn't really, you know, think about going it, but doing it, but.
And why not?
Well, I don't like being coerced into doing things. You pay for it, and you know, you didn't even consult me.
Oh, we had this plan for some time. What?
I didn't know.
It was on the calendar.
Calendar? What calendar?
See? But you jumped in the car. You didn't see the calendar, but you jumped in the car.
Well, I thought we were going somewhere. I wasn't quite sure we were going to the retreat. No.
So you're here. Why are you here?
I'm here because, you know, it's important to you, it's important then to me, and, you know, let's do this thing, let's get it over with. You know, right? Yeah. For real.
I don't know what it is with you. I mean...
Madrid, I'm trying to do what's right for us. You know, babe, I'm trying to do what's good for us. I'm trying to keep it real, trying to keep it together. Yeah.
I have a problem believing that.
Believe it.
I really do.
No.
You know, we talked about having kids and doing all these other things, but then, no, you wanted to be the kid. You don't want to grow up.
Oh, no. Don't pull up that little boy stuff on me.
Oh, come on.
Nah.
But you're playing video games. I mean, you could have...
Oh, here we go with the video games. You got something about video games now?
You have a problem with sharing. That's what it is.
I have a problem with sharing?
Yeah.
You have a problem with sharing your emotions sometimes.
You're riding in my car.
Your car? I thought this was our car. Our car. Our GPS. Our radio.
Our GPS has got us lost.
I got us... Right. Okay, that's where we're going to the gas station. I'm going to get all the stuff. Make you happy so we can go and get everything. Make it all humpy and happy and cozy and stuff like that. Right, Madrid? Right, baby? Isn't that what you want? Yeah. My neck hurts. It really does.
I know why your neck hurts. Pain in the neck.
Same here. This retreat that you talked me into going, you know, and it's gonna be good, right?
You sound like you don't want to go.
No, I'm going. I'm in the car. We're going.
I made you get in the car, right?
No. I'm fine. I'm fine with it. I'm
all
fine
right.
With it. Yeah.
That's good. And,
Man, my neck hurts a little bit over here. It's warm in here. Yeah, well, what are we waiting for? Let's go, come on.
What are you looking at?
I wasn't looking at anything.
Okay.
Let's make this turn, let's make it happen, let's go.
I sure hope it was worth the argument we're gonna have later on.
What argument? Mm-hmm. What argument? Mm-hmm. What are you talking about?
I saw you looking.
Looking at?
That's one thing, men.
What?
Never satisfied with what they have.
Looking at?
No respect.
What? What do you think I'm looking at?
You know what?
What?
Cut your eyes out.
Oh.
Oh, wait.
Don't touch me. Who are you?
You were in an accident.
Accident? What kind of accident?
Well, technically, I hit you with my car.
You hit me with your car?
But you came out of nowhere.
But pedestrians have the right of way.
And you wasn't in a crosswalk either.
Okay. Well, how did I get here?
Well, I brought you here after the accident.
Why? Because, I mean, you could have took me somewhere.
I mean, you're right, but how you were dressed, you know, I don't...
Hold up. How I was dressed? What do you mean
No disrespect whatsoever, but you didn't have an ID either.
Okay.
So, I had to bring you here.
What happened last night?
Nothing. I brought you here, laid you down, put the cover on you. That's it.
Okay. How long have I been here?
Technically, for about 9 hours.
9 hours?
Yeah.
Where was I going? Where was I coming from?
That's what I was trying to figure out. So you don't remember?
No, not really.
How can't you remember where you were coming from?
I don't know. I just don't remember. Last thing I remember was in my house. I was getting ready, getting dressed. Shanika's party, dancing to my song. Do the chicken wing. I don't know how I ended up from there to here.
You don't smell the alcohol on you right now?
I know I might have been drinking, but that's besides the point right now.
I was only going about 15 miles an hour.
Okay. Whether you was going 20, 35, or 15 miles per hour, you still hit me.
Well, that's how it may have seemed, but I know what happened.
I'm about to go. I'm about to leave.
But wait, no, you can't.
Don't touch me!
Oh, no, wait. Hold on, listen. Time out. I'm gonna fix my chair. And we're going to talk, okay?
Okay.
We're going to keep our hands to ourselves and just have a conversation.
All right.
I don't want to get disrespected anymore. I don't want to disrespect you. Okay.
I was disrespecting you.
By hitting me, touching me, yes, you were. My name is Kyle, for one. Okay? This is my place. And that's the start, okay? That's the start. Now, you don't remember anything.
No. Besides those things that I told you. Do I work with you? Were you at the party?
I didn't know anything about no party. I was coming home from work.
At the party. I don't.
Last night, okay?
I'm sure you were driving off of the road into me.
Positive.
Were you drinking?
No. At all, whatsoever.
I still don't know how I got here. I mean, I know what you're telling me, but that doesn't mean anything to me.
You're right. And just know I didn't do anything. I didn't touch you. Okay.
You better not have touched me. I will call my people. I don't play that. But can you turn the air conditioner on? It's hot.
I mean, I felt fine. I'm sorry. That's maybe because you're under the blanket, but, you know, I will turn the central air on. Okay. Just give me a second.
Give me something to drink. You know, I guess, I mean, I'm here now. I got to stay.
Okay. Yeah. I'll get you something to drink. You just don't go nowhere, okay?
Where's my water?
Okay, I'm coming. Miss Impatient.
How long does it take? Just ask for some water.
Goodness.
Is this tap?
Is that a problem?
I don't do tap. You got some bottled water? That ain't sanitary.
Okay.
I don't know what you're trying to do to me. Slept for 9 hours. And can you turn the air on? It's still hot in here.
I can't do everything at once.
Thank you.
Here you go. Can I have a seat? Is everything fine?
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm okay now.
Good. Do you think you remember what you used to do for a living?
No. Your guess is as good as mine.
Any hobbies?
It looks like I like to shop. Nice jewelry.
So basically like every other woman, right?
Yeah, I guess. Kind
of. And that's all you can think of?
Mm-hmm. I like to sing. Kind of have a tune in my head now.
Yeah, really?
I could totally make a song out of this situation. Crazy brother driving, tried to run me off the road. Slept 9 hours, brought me to his home. Brought me tap water, and that's not what I drink. But he made up for it. Got me a bottle of water. Yeah. I think I like to say.
You sound wonderful just now.
You think?
Really? Like.
Oh, goodness. Well, thank you.
Thanks. Wow. Mm. So
you have a lovely home.
Thank you. Thanks. But maybe I'm, you know, just throwing this out. Maybe you were some type of performer, you know, music. Because from the sounds of it.
No, that's not it. Why didn't you take me to the hospital again? I'm sorry, I'm just trying to understand.
Well, first, it's a perception, you know. A beautiful drunk girl, you know, nice clothes.
Well, I'm beautiful now, and my clothes are nice.
Yeah, you know, and...
You didn't think so before.
I mean, I had reason, you know. I always thought you were beautiful, but, you know, when you jumped up, you know. But if I would have took you, you know, I would have been to blame. And how you got up would have proved that.
I guess you're right.
But you look like you're in pain now. I mean...
Yeah, I don't know. It's getting worse. Maybe it's swelling, it feels like.
Oh, man. I mean, should we go to the hospital?
Well, I don't want to get you in trouble. I mean...
You know what? From talking to you now after getting you the water, you know, you're a beautiful woman. So unique. I think it's worth me getting in trouble.
Did you say unique?
Yeah.
That's it. That's me.
What do you mean?
My name's Unique.
Oh, now we're getting somewhere. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you too. What is it, Kyle?
Yes.
Kyle. Nice to meet you. I'm Unique.
Good.
Right. Yeah, well, you gotta differentiate the mother of your children versus your girlfriend. They met at the same time. How did this happen? Wow, you're slipping, dude. Yeah, I'll watch the game with you next week. Okay. Yeah. Peace.
Oh my God.
My brother. This guy. This guy is. He got caught. No. He's really got issues. My niece's mother, which is his quote unquote baby mama.
Mm-hmm.
And his girlfriend.
That's what I gathered. Mm-hmm.
Right. So, they kind of, you feel what I'm saying?
How do you two know? I mean, you just got here like...
You're a dumbass, basically. You left my number in her phone.
And he was asking for my advice. I've never been in that situation, so...
Mm-hmm. What are you supposed to say?
I don't know. Anyway, I'll deal with him later. Let me turn it right here off. Okay, hold up. Are you pay the bill?
Oh yeah, the AC went out yesterday.
Right.
And when I called, they said, "Oh, we can't be over there until Tuesday."
Tuesday.
Yeah.
Anyway, look, you could have called me and just told me we could meet at my house.
That's too much trouble.
Too much trouble. How do you survive in this heat?
It's not that bad.
Anyway.
It's not that bad.
Really. Okay. So where are we?
Well, you know my ideas, my vision.
where we're going with this whole project. What we really have to focus on now right. is our budgeting stuff, because we've got like a week.
Right.
So we have to compile all of this and send it off and hope that they give us this grant. They will give us this grant. They will give us this grant.
Right.
I just gotta believe that.
Come on. What did you tell me? Whatever your mind can conceive or perceive is reality.
I know.
So
I want to present this. I don't want miscellaneous, extraneous expenses in there because, you know. Come on.
It ain't sweet, no. Come on.
They have these things called trash cans.
You know? Some of the things you do around me, you can't throw away.
Okay.
What are some of the services that the facility will offer that are alternatives for the traditional method of medicine?
Well, I'm looking at things that can benefit the public in both an emotional way and a physical way. So things like counseling, of course.
Right.
I'm looking at acupuncture and herbal medicine.
Mm-hmm. It's like acupuncture.
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, I know people are, you know, worried about needles, but that's part of the education process.
Herbal medicine?
Yeah. No, not like that. Stop it. So, things of that nature, massage, chiropractic, all kinds of services that can be made more affordable than some of the Western types of healthcare in this economy. So we have to look at a way to market it in a way that really what?
Nothing.
That the community understands.
Right.
So anyway.
What? What?
Nothing. I'm just distracted. Okay. So, budgeting stuff. How can you help me kind of corral all of this?
Well, how much equity do we have to invest before we seek any type of support from any outside entities?
I'm sorry. you're going to have to break it down into layman's terms because...
Put it like this.
Okay.
We don't have any money. Based on what we have versus what we need to start this up, what's a ballpark range in which you think we may need to start up this particular idea in which we're able to facilitate a center that's based on alternative medicine?
We're looking at... Let's see, startup costs. What are you doing?
Right. You would have did it anyway.
Okay.
Back to what you were saying. Hold up. Can I be honest with you?
Sure.
There's this way that you seem to slide your hands to push your hair behind your ears. I like that. You know, I miss movie night. Movie night. Sweatpants, no makeup, hair pulled back. What happened to that? Have you ever noticed, listen, check this out. Have you ever noticed when we've got a bottle of Chardonnay and you just seem to have a couple glasses or whatever, and I can tell when your fade is cussed, your teeth start to clink the glass. not to mention chewing. Chewy. Your neighbor's teacup Yorkie. Normally he just comes and just like hunches on my leg. I mean, I don't know. I miss those times. And I hate to take it away from what we're working on, but I miss that.
Yeah. I have to say that I enjoy those times.
See, yeah, you're doing it now. Are you nervous?
Well, I shouldn't be.
So, I mean, why are you doing the whole... And I noticed you're wearing two rings instead of one on your feet today. What's up with that? Rings. This one.
Yeah. Well, you know me and all my miscellaneous jewelry.
You know, why do you put up with the guys that you deal with?
Maybe there's a part of me that thinks that there's nothing better than these ridiculous guys.
Look, you crack your knuckles, you push your hair behind your ears when you're nervous, when you're faded, you clank your teeth on your glass, you tap your feet. You're the only person that knows since my brother passed that I take antidepressants, and it's something that I don't share with everyone, and you don't pass judgment, which allows me to feel comfortable when I'm around you. You know, you're attractive. It's something that I can't put into words, but it's other things about you that make me feel comfortable. Things that are very personal that others don't really know about, that you console me on. I mean, you have you nurture, and that's something I never received from my mom growing up. She was always so busy. You know my mom. That I've never experienced someone that actually cared or gave a fuck about my feelings. So I can't help but feel the way in which I do, if that makes any sense. And I apologize. I know this is probably the wrong place and time, and I know that I'm having trouble translating my thoughts and my feelings into words, but you're just everything. Too much, wow. Huh?
I have to say that I'm glad that you are telling me this. It means something to me. I mean, it really does. I just don't know how this fits into all of... I'm always thinking about the future, you know? Right. And my brain has been so overwhelmed by...
Okay, what about the future don't you understand? It's not written. Which means we can influence the direction in which it travels, unless you decide to just jump in the passenger seat and allow it to take you on its course.
Well, I've never been one to jump in the passenger seat, but I really don't know how. I mean, what if we're gonna get this grant? What if we get this grant? And what if this?
We're gonna get the grant. Look, we're gonna get the grant. Don't worry about that. We're gonna get the grant.
But what I'm saying is, if we were to take this to another level and it didn't work, what the hell do we do then? We've got all of this time invested in this.
You don't know what?
I don't know what direction.
Look, I miss movie nights. No makeup, sweatpants, t-shirt.
We can still do that. We can still do that, right? I gotta think about all this. I don't know.
About what?
I'm not sure what I need right now.
Take your glasses off.
Why?
Just take them off. Wow. Has anyone ever told you how beautiful you are? Hold up. see your eyes. I'm sure they do, but they're fucking lames. Why do you keep dealing with these lame cats? I mean,
this is too much right now. I don't. Mm-hmm.
Fine, take a minute. Take a moment to yourself. Do I need to leave? How about I go to the bathroom and you kind of ponder on financials.
Okay.
It looks like we need to kind of get this together. I'm sorry.
It's just, I just have to think.
Okay, I'll be right back.
Okay.
You okay?
Yeah, I'll be fine.
What time is it?
You got 6 hours.
I don't know, Diane. I'm just so scared. I don't know. I don't know if I'm gonna be a good wife or if I can be that good wife.
You scared?
Yeah, I'm scared.
We talked about this right after he asked you. We talked about it a few months after that. I know you remember. You were drinking, but you remember. I know you do. You had a little bit to drink. Every time it was the same thing. Oh, I love him. I want to have his kids.
I don't know who you getting me twisted up with, but every time we talked about it, I was clear.
Either way, we talked about it. We talked about it. So,
you know I love him. Come on, girl. Like,
so what's up?
I'm just scared. I don't know if I'm...
Look, you know, honestly, I believe that it's one thing to be nervous about walking down an aisle, all eyes on you, 75 people. And it's another thing to be scared. I mean, it's another thing to be afraid to do something that you committed to doing.
But I'm saying, like, look at our backgrounds. Look at where we both coming from. You know, my family, my father was gone before I was 12. Because they got divorced. His father was gone at a young age because they got divorced. So we both had to grow up watching our mothers or whoever was still around struggle by themselves because the person that they said that they thought was going to be there for them for the rest of their life, the same person that they had children with, the same person that they was with, decided that they couldn't be there anymore.
I mean, I understand that. Divorce is something...
That's why it's... That's even more... An even bigger reason why it's terrifying. Divorce rate is going what? Exactly. But all I'm trying to do is just love this man. And I'm scared
that... We all know that more than half of the people in the world who gets... Or the country who gets married get a divorce.
Yeah, but look. You said... All right, you told me... Remember when it happened with your parents, right?
Yeah.
Okay. How did that affect you in relationships?
You know what? This is your day, and I'm gonna bring it back because we're not talking about me. Divorce is. I'm not saying that it's inevitable. I know that it happens to people, but what you have to do is the both of you, not just you, not just him, but you have to. You really do have to put God first. And have you done that? Really, should be the question.
Yes.
You have. You can honestly say that not listening to me or anybody else and what they think and not listening to what you think you want or need.
Yes.
You've seriously done that.
I just need you to...
Has he done that? Can you answer me that?
He does anything in his power to make sure that I'm happy. Anything. And you know, whatever past he had, but when I met him... He was a man only for me.
I know. We both know that.
I've never experienced anything like that in my life.
Look, I know that Charles used to be somewhat of a playboy. I mean, I do know that. But, and I asked you if you knew whether he put God first in his life. Are you for sure that you are the one that he has done that.
Yes, this is what I'm trying to say. This man is, first let me say, this man is everything and then some of what I've ever wanted in my life. And to think that a man as wonderful as he can pick me, that's amazing. He can get any woman he wants in this world.
I mean, so why are you getting married?
He picks me. Why am I getting married? Because he will do anything to make me happy.
I mean,
yes, the love is there, but you don't want to hear about the love. Let's talk about the fact that he has always been there. I'm talking about he's been there in ways that, you know, I love you to death. But he's been there in ways that you and my mother and my sister have not been able to be there for me. I've never experienced that from one single person in my entire life.
Okay.
I'm afraid it's me. Look, I'm afraid that I can't.
I've heard a lot of stories, okay? You know, in what I do, I hear a lot of stories. And people get married for some really, really fucked up reasons. And all I'm doing is trying to ask you, what is your reason for getting married? Most people don't ask themselves that. And the way I think about it, because you know I got my thoughts, I think about it as, it's like differentiating the difference between a career and a job, okay? A job is something you go to because you have to. And I wouldn't advise anybody to go into a marriage and start doing stuff because they have to, okay? That's not what it's about, but a career. That's something, even the hard stuff, even the stuff that's so undesirable, you do it because you want and you desire and you know, but that overall reason for doing it will pay off and you know that it's because it's what you love.
Because this is my career choice, but this is all I'm saying. My mother and my father, they made a career choice. If you want to use that, they made a career choice. But then years down the path, they found out they weren't the same person that they started out with. That's why I'm scared. Like, what if I'm not what he wants 20 years from now? I don't think my heart can take that.
And that's why I said it's really not about you. It really isn't. It really is about what I said before. I mean, it really is about putting God first. But let's just say, and I know that you do believe that there's one person. We talked about this before. Out of 6.9 billion people in the world, that there was one person that was made for you. Now, I mentioned people get married for some real crazy things. I mean, some people, it's just something else to scratch off the list next to getting a master's degree and buying a house. Oh, yeah, maybe by the time I'm 35, I need to be married. But it's got to be about more than that. It really has to be about more than that. And if you can tell me, if you can honestly tell me that Charles is the one, he's one out of 6.9 billion. He's one in 6.9 billion. If you can honestly tell me that, then I will do it. I will put on the ugly purple dress.
Hold up.
I put it on.
Hold up. Don't you speak that blasphemy up.
You know what? You know it's ugly.
In my bathroom.
You know it's ugly.
It is a beautiful dress.
Okay, but look. Okay.
Yes, and it's okay, a beautiful color.
I'll put the beautiful dress on.
Yes.
I'll put the beautiful ugly purple dress on.
Oh, see.
And I will go to the church, and I'll be there when you walk down the aisle. But if you can't answer me that question, then you know what? I'll still support you. I'll be sitting here in this chair in this bathroom. Which is just so, I mean, when are you going to clean this thing? but I'll be here for it's 5 hours and 52 minutes left until you walk down the aisle. I'll be here. If you can't tell me that that's one in 6.9 billion, I will be here.
I don't think you understand. I don't think there's anything wrong with him and my choice in him or his choice in me. That's all fine. I'm just afraid that I may not be what he wants in some time. I don't know if I'm beautiful enough to hold on.
I can't believe I'm hearing this. I can't. That's what this is all about.
Please don't downplay my emotion.
I'm not. You know I like to joke around a lot, but sometimes I find it hard to take you seriously because I can't believe I'm hearing this. But this, at this moment in time, I cannot believe I'm hearing this. Get up. Come on. Get up. Come on. Stand up. Come on. Look at that. Look at that. You see what I see? Do you? So what's the problem?
No. I don't know if I'm beautiful enough. 20, 30 years from now, I don't know if he's gonna see what he says he sees now. So nobody.
Zena, you are beautiful, okay? 20, 30 years from now, nobody looks the same 20, 30 years from now. But look at that. Look at it. You know what I see? I see a giving person. I see someone who is spiritual, who tries to be perfect, even though you're not. But you at least try to be. That's more than what most people can say. Someone who puts most people before themselves all the time. And someone who loves the Lord. That's what I see. And I think that's what he sees too. Beauty is about more than this. Because this, you're right. 20, 30 years from now, it's not going to look the same. It's not. But what's in here will. As long as this in here stays the same, he's gonna love you. He will love you. So what's it gonna be?
Chris, do you think I'm a bad person?
What made you ask me that?
Just want to know, do you think I'm a bad person?
You have to ask yourself that question. Where are you going with all this?
I don't know. Trying to figure some things out, you know?
Well, let me know. I'll help you if I can. It's on your mind.
I know that this is wrong, and I'm so weak when it comes to you, and I don't know how to control it. I don't know.
Nobody's perfect. Sometimes you have to go the wrong path in order to find the right path, regardless of who that might end up being with or who you may hurt at that time. It's life. It's an ongoing struggle. I know. I've been there.
I don't want to be this weak, you know what I mean? I know God didn't make me like this. I don't know what it is about you.
Trust me, you are not a weak individual. Not in my eyes. Never have, never will be. It's gonna be alright. No matter what it is, it's gonna be alright.
What is this? This new Chris? Holding my hand and expressing yourself and looking me deep in my eyes and like all this honesty and feeling. Where is this coming from?
I can't vouch.
Since when?
I meant what I said.
What? What?
I love you. Why are you looking at me like that? Why?
I don't know. What do you want from me?
I don't want nothing from you. I just want you.
Chris, honey. This was just supposed to be sex. Do you remember?
Yeah, I remember.
That's what it's supposed to be, is sex, and you bring in feelings and...
It wasn't just sex for me.
I'm engaged.
Engaged? So why are you with me? What, I was just some conquest? Why didn't you tell me?
I don't know.
You don't know?
No. What do you want
who
from me? What
who is he?
Doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. He's everything that my family wants for me. He fits the mold and you don't.
What do you want? What do you want?
It doesn't matter what I want.
All right.
Chris, where are you going?
Call me when you get up in the morning.
Well, I'm sorry, but what happened else is?
I ain't trying to hear that. I'm not trying to hear that.
Ice, you let her affect you so bad.
What am I supposed to do?
You know how she is.
What am I supposed to do? This woman talks bad to me almost every day. What am I supposed to do?
I mean, what can we do? We're under her roof. That's just the reality of it.
It doesn't matter. She still does not need to talk to me like that at all.
I mean, I know that. I talked to her before. Mm-hmm. I told her to bite her lip when she's around you. But you know how she is.
When did you talk to her? Yeah.
I talked to her before, man. You know that.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
The thing is that she can kick us out right now if she wanted to. Where are we going to go after that if she did?
That's my point. What are we doing?
Look, you know I'm working hard. You know I'm working hard with this music producing thing. I got new artists coming in. I'm setting up concerts. I mean, I know the money ain't flowing right. I mean, I'm trying to look for other jobs, but you know they're denying me. I'm getting laid off. You know how hard it is out there?
But she's not even coming at you. She's coming at me. I mean, I'm going to school. I'm working. I'm trying my best. I make sure she doesn't have to lift a finger when I'm here. It doesn't matter. She's still snapping at me.
I know that. She's my aunt. But I told her, you know, your goals. I told her you ain't playing around with me. We've been together so long, she should know that by now.
I have 1 year left in school. Just one. Just one. And all I ask is for when I graduate, we're not in the same situation. Like, I want so much more for us. I want to have a family. Do you ever think about having a family? Think about that?
I do. I do every day. I think about it every day.
Do you want kids?
Of course. Of course I do. Look, you've been sticking by my side for the longest. And right now, I need you more than ever. You know what's rough right now.
Eric, you know I care about you. And like you said, I've been here for you. But we just got to try. We got to try harder than this. We both do.
I know, Aisha. I know. But you have to give me time. You have to. Look, you've been the best thing that ever happened to me. You've been supportive, faithful. And right now, I need you. I need you the most. Stick by me. Do it for us. Do it for me.
I mean, I'm here. I've been here. Then what?
It shouldn't be a problem. You should stay right here with me. And everything will flow.
I hope so.
It will.
Hey, Daddy. It's okay, thank you.
I know you've been busy. It's okay, I know you got a lot going on. Okay, I love you too. Okay, bye.
How's he doing? What's wrong, man? You all right?
He was asking about my birthday. Just wanted to wish me a happy belated birthday.
Okay.
You know, just talking to him just made me think about a lot of things that I was really trying to forget.
What do you mean?
Remember, like, about a month ago when I was, like, really, really sick? And you kept asking, like, what was going on? And I told you it was nothing, and I went to the doctor. And I came back and didn't say anything else about it.
I mean, yeah, I remember that. What's going on?
I've been trying to find a way to tell you this. But it's just, with everything going on,
Aisha, what are you trying to say?
I just couldn't find the words to tell you I had an abortion.
What? Aisha, what are you thinking?
I know.
I didn't
know what else to do. We're not ready. You're not ready.
Oh, my God.
I mean, look where we're at.
What do you mean where we're at? It doesn't matter where we're at. That's my child in you.
Yeah, your aunt already doesn't like me. And if I'm pregnant...
She has nothing to do with our situation, Aisha.
What do you think she's going to do? What do you really think she's going to do? You were just talking about her putting us out where we're going
to do. That has nothing to do with you.
If I was pregnant, she'd put us out, what would we do? We can't even afford to stay here. What would we do?
What are you thinking?
It's my body, Eric. It's my body. 9 months is a long time to carry a child. And I still have to go to work. I still have to go to school. I still have to take care of you. That's what I was thinking about us. We're not ready.
You were thinking about us, but not even the child, though.
We're not ready. Of course I'm thinking about the child. Where would the child sleep?
Aisha, having a place, money, has nothing to do with a life.
It has everything to do with it, Eric. Everything.
I can't believe
it. We're barely making it. How are we going to afford Pampers? How are we going to afford formula? Daycare.
We'll figure out a way. You have to be by my side.
I am by your side, Eric. This is why I didn't tell you. This is exactly why I didn't tell you.
Don't you think you've been selfish?
You can't even look at me. You can't even look at me.
I want to have a family. Do you ever think about having a family? Think about that?
I do. I do every day. I think about it every day. I can't believe this, man.
I didn't know what else to do.
You know what, Aisha, man? That was a selfish ass act. This is unbelievable, man. You have my kid in you, and then all of a sudden you don't even think about us. You were selfish.
I was thinking about us.
Man, I can't even deal with you. I can't deal with you.
What do you mean you can't deal with me? What do you mean you can't deal with me? This is why I didn't tell you in the first place. Eric.
Look, you've been the best thing that ever happened to me. You've been supportive, faithful.
What am I supposed to do now?
I feel the same way. I'm not adding to my playlist. No, I told him that the other day. Who cares? All right. I'll do it.
Jay?
Yo.
Where you at?
Upstairs.
You will not believe who I just saw.
Who?
Tanya M from the radio station.
Which one?
You know, the one that does the relationship and marriage counseling.
No.
Where's my purse?
That's right behind that pillow.
I went all the way to the store and forgot my purse, so. Where's my phone?
Phone's right here. You left it. You left your phone.
Wow. So what's up? What are you doing?
Waiting for you.
We going to the movies?
No, I don't think I'm gonna wait for like going to the movies right now. At all.
Why not?
Just got a lot on my mind, that's all. I mean, you figure, been here for like 4 days. We haven't spent no time together. Maybe we can spend some one-on-one talk, catch up on a few things.
Okay, sounds like a good idea.
How the social life? Going out, hitting the clubs up.
A little.
Not much.
Just a little bit. Here and there. You know Keely, she always wants me to go out with her. Get some drinks to take her mind off of work.
Keely. The high school girl, right?
Yeah, I went to high school.
Wow,
yeah.
Party girl. I can only imagine what those nights be like.
No, she's calmed down a lot. She's different now, so.
Different?
Mm-hmm.
You think you're different too?
No, I wouldn't say that.
Right.
What are you getting at?
Nothing at all. So, you met up with any special, you know, new male friends, anything like that you want to talk about?
No.
No?
No.
None at all. Just so, you're just going out?
Going out and having a good time with my girl.
Right. So, you haven't met a new special man in your life?
No.
No.
What are these questions about?
I'm just asking. I told you we're just going to sit here and talk, catch up on a few things. That's
sounds like you're trying to get at something. What are you?
I mean, you did leave your phone here. And I went through it thinking I'm about to go check out some of your latest profile pics.
You went through my phone?
Yeah, I went through your phone.
For what? Why would you do that?
Like, check I don't out, go through said, your check phone. Check out some of your pics you have done in the past.
Okay, but that was years ago. But still,
I didn't think it would
I
be
thought
a problem.
We were past that.
We are passive, but like I said, I went through your phone to look at some of your pictures. Ran across a few text messages that I probably shouldn't have ran across. Who's Mike?
A friend.
A friend?
Mm-hmm.
Is he a special friend or you're dating? I mean, who's...
No, we go out for coffee a couple times. We have gone out a couple times.
But I just asked you, have you been going out with a special man? You said no.
I know what you asked me, and I told you.
No.
I told you that I go out with friends and Keely.
Something you want to tell me?
No. Mike is just a friend. We're okay.
And y'all just go out to grab coffee and...
Yeah.
So y'all haven't been out on dates, you haven't spent the night at his house, he hasn't spent the night here, none of that?
No.
Man, I'm just trying to get down to the bottom of something that I already know. Like I said, I read through your phone, read the text messages, and to make matters even worse, I talked to Mike on the phone.
Okay.
I mean, I felt like...
What did he say? He called to talk to me. Why would you have
Because
he's in my phone.
He's in your phone as my boo.
Okay, so.
I mean, I'm asking you. I mean, you can just be honest with me. Let me know what's going on. Because obviously it seems like I'm telling you things that you already know.
Okay, so Mike and I have gone out on dates a few times.
Is that where you were last night? Now, before you answer that question, I said I talked to Mike.
Yeah.
And you say you went to the store a few minutes ago, right?
Yes. I went to the store and I forgot my purse and my phone and I came back here.
Were you supposed to meet Mike on your way to the store? Or were you supposed to go to Mike's house? This is just not working out.
What are you saying? No,
I mean, this told you about the text messages. Told you about me speaking to Mike on the phone, so therefore I know things that you're not telling me. You love me, right?
Yes.
So why can't you just be completely honest with me? Listen, this, just like I said, this is just not working. Long distance has really, really, really hurt us.
Yes, it has. It really has. It's someone to talk to, and he was there. So, it got complicated.
Well, just like you needed somebody to talk to, so did I. I've been seeing someone, Alex. For the last 4 months.
Who is she? 4 months?
Yeah, her name's Stephanie. She works at the job. Knew her for about a year, she came in.
So you mean to tell me you gone through my phone trying to make me feel bad and you've been seeing someone also?
I went through your phone, yeah, and I ran across some things I probably should not have ran across.
Okay, but you're out doing the same exact thing, so.
But the situation is different.
No, the situation is not different.
Stephanie knows about you. Mike had no idea about me.
What does it matter? The only thing that matters is that you did the same exact thing that you're sitting here accusing me of.
No, I'm not. I'm accusing you of lying. You lied to me.
And you lied to me also by not telling me.
I didn't lie to you. I just didn't tell you. You didn't ask me.
That's the same thing.
No, it's not.
Yes, it is.
No, it's not. It's not the same thing at all.
How is it not the same thing?
Because I was dancing when I came here to tell you that. She's 6 weeks pregnant. Just like you needed somebody there for you, I needed somebody there for me. I mean, things happen, Alex, and you know that. We don't see each other, what, four or five months apart?
Wait.
Since I've been out in Seattle?
Pregnant?
She's pregnant.
I cannot believe you. You sit here and throw Mike up in my face and you have someone pregnant?
Alex.
Are you serious?
Yeah, I'm serious. But that's why I came out here to try to work things out with you. But you're sitting here lying to me? And what if I said I was getting ready to throw everything away with her and just take care of my baby?
That is too late. You already have a family there. You have your whole little family.
And I messed up and I'm a man, I can admit that. But you're not admitting to anything. And you're lying in my face right now.
It doesn't matter anymore.
It matters to me.
No, it doesn't. It doesn't matter.
It does matter.
Everything, the years that we put into this relationship, everything is, it just doesn't mean anything.
It don't mean nothing to you.
Because
if it did, you would sit here and keep it real with me. Be completely honest and tell me everything that's going on. I just told you everything that's going on with me. Her name's Stephanie. I've known her for a year. We've been dating seriously for the last 3-4 months. Unfortunately, she's pregnant. I messed up.
No, you didn't. You did exactly what you wanted to do. It's just... And how am I supposed to deal with you having a child in Seattle?
I don't even... It's not going to work. This, us, yeah. we're not going to work.
Exactly. I can't believe you. I cannot believe you.
And I can't believe you.
Just give me my space. I really don't even want to see you anymore. So.
Well, I just go grab my bags. Yeah, grab my bags. Probably take a cab to my house.
Yeah, you should do that. You should leave now.
That's it.
That's it. Get out. Get out.
WKEB 98.7, it's your girl Tanya M here, giving you the best advice for your love and your life. It's the Love and Life Lesson Show, discussing a hot one today. The question is, are women the new men? Now, this question came up as I was reading the book 10th Letter by my girl Kayana Ebony Brown, and I had to put this one out there for my listeners. Are women becoming the new men? What does that mean? Are we separating our emotional selves from our physical selves? Or are we looking at our mothers and simply saying, that's not going to be me? Women today are completely different from the way women used to be. Or let me ask this question. Are we just naturally evolving that women have had to step up to the plate and be mommy, daddy, king, queen, everything? Is that simply it? I need to hear from you. What are your thoughts on this one? Caller number one. Let me know what you think.
Okay, I'll talk to you soon. All right, bye-bye. Hey, babe. Oh, what's wrong with you?
Nothing.
Nothing.
Just trying to make some dinner for you, you know.
So sweet.
Take care of you.
You always do.
How was your day?
It was long. I am so tired. I'm beat. Dealing with all these people, these clients, trying to get these houses together. What are your plans this summer? Are you teaching? Are you doing summer school? Or what were you thinking?
Well, you know I'm teaching. That's not, you shouldn't even question that. And as far as what I plan to do this summer, I want to take some of my students and go camping, maybe a couple camps, do some life skills stuff, show them how to be young men. You know?
No, Lawrence. Why can't you think of, you know, maybe quitting your job?
Why would I do that?
I just think that would be best for us. You could just focus on being at home.
Best for us?
Yeah.
I think it might be best for you. I mean, I'm
perfectly... Well, why do you think it would be best for me, Lawrence? I'm perfectly content
with what I do. I give back to my community. I make a difference
in people's lives. Wait, hold on. Hello? No, I said Friday. I'm just going. Work out whatever you need to work out. Hold on. Hello? Yeah, no, Friday. That's it. I don't know. Pull your strings. Do whatever you need to do, okay? I'll call you back later. All right.
Why every time I'm in a discussion, you always on your BlackBerry?
Oh, my gosh.
Or something. Why is that?
This is how I get my job. This is how I run my business,
leave work
okay?
at work. You at home. Leave work at work. I'm trying to talk to you. You cut me off right in the middle of speech. Are you serious? What's wrong with you?
I got a phone call. What do you expect me to say, Lawrence?
Why are you always on call?
What do you want me to do? Why are you always really? On call? You want me to quit my job? Then how will we eat? How will we live if I quit my job, huh? I don't understand that.
We live just fine. Believe me.
No, we don't. We not on your teacher's salary.
You want to live, but we live just fine. We'll get there. We'll make it.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
On a teacher's salary, $35,000? I don't think so. You gave up that principal position for $35,000.
Because I love what I do. Is there something wrong with that?
You love what you do.
I don't think you love what you do. I think it's all about the money with you.
Oh, I love my job, honey. Yeah. I love my job.
You love what your job can give you. That's what you love.
You damn right. What's wrong with that?
A lot wrong with that. Coming home at the end of the day, not having a peace of mind, being on call 24/7. There's a lot wrong with
that. Look, you make sacrifices for the things that you want, okay? I want to be well-to-do, okay? I'm preparing for our future. I'm getting our house built. I'm saving money for our children's college tuition that we don't even have yet. You don't even appreciate me.
Okay, let me ask you. I never
asked you to do anything. All I asked you to do was quit your job, and that's just too much. God, sometimes you seem so ungrateful. You should be lucky to have somebody take care of you. I'm grateful, but I'm not. There's plenty of men out here that would want a woman like me to take care of them. I don't ask anything of you.
First of all, I don't ask you to take care of me. I appreciate what you do for me, but I don't ask you to do that. I never have, but I appreciate it. But you don't have to throw it in my face.
You don't act like it.
Hold on, you ain't got to throw it in my face all the time either.
Why can't you just let me take care of you? I really don't understand what the problem is with that.
It's not about the money. Sometimes people do things because they love what they do. Sometimes I don't even think you love what you do. I just think you love making money.
I do love making money, so.
Let me ask you this. If we have kids, what kind of school would you want them to go to? Public? Private?
Are you serious? Private school. End of story. There's no need to even discuss that, Lawrence. I need my children to have the best education possible. You're right. You shouldn't ask you that question.
Because you don't know why. Because you want them to act all snooty and arrogant like you. Walk around
with their nose, turning their nose
up. It ain't about low blow. It's the truth. You always on the phone. Nah. I got this deal. I made this. I made that. I mean, life ain't all about money. You know, what about love and respect? Matter of fact, I don't even think you respect me anymore. Because all you talk about is my salary.
I do not.
Yes, you do. You throw it in my face every day. Then you don't even pay me any attention half the time.
When you come into my house, you don't even show me
the respect. You show that phone and that conversation about that money more respect than you show me.
This is my job.
Don't bring work home.
You just don't understand, Lawrence.
Understand what? What is it to understand?
You don't
that
understand.
Your work is more important than me, us, our relationship, our future?
I never said that.
Yeah, okay.
I never said
that. Well, let me ask you this, Michelle. What would you do, God forbid, if something happened where you wasn't able to make $35,000 a month? Or if you happened to have some kind of sick illness or something where you couldn't do that, what would you do? Because I know my $35,000 a year is perfectly suitable for my living.
Lawrence, you're being unrealistic.
How am I being unrealistic? Because I'm not living above my means? Because I want to take care of my community, give back? I'm being unrealistic. I think you being unrealistic.
No, I'm not.
What have you done for anybody other than for yourself? Okay, yeah, you pay my rent every now and then when I'm in a rut. But I don't ask you to do that.
I don't
ask you to put me down every day.
I don't.
Yes, you do.
No, I don't.
Tell me I should leave my job, what I do. I don't make enough money. Why don't you go find one of them white collar suits, lawyer type brothers?
Lawrence, I want you. I don't.
I don't even know why you with me.
What are you talking about?
I'm serious.
About?
I'm in here cooking dinner for you. You still on the phone? Yeah. I mean, come on.
Lawrence, I'm just trying
to. You don't even show me no respect no more.
I don't mean to disrespect you, Lawrence. I'm sorry if you feel like I disrespect you. I really don't mean to.
I'm getting sick of it. I just don't know. I don't know where to go anymore. Where we going anymore? I don't know. I don't even know if I want to marry you anymore.
What?
I'm serious.
What are you talking about?
I can't take it.
Lawrence, I don't even know where all this is coming from.
It's coming from. It's you should see it every day. It's the same thing.
I think
you talk about money in this. What about us? What about respecting what your man do for a living? Giving back to the community.
Lawrence, I think you're overreacting.
No, I'm not overreacting. Nah. I see things perfectly fine. I don't think you see things right. I don't think you see things anymore.
Lawrence,
I don't think you see things the way we need to see. I don't think we're on the same page anymore. I'm serious. I can't take somebody that's gonna put their business in front of our relationship. You need to think about that. You need to get your priorities straight. You gotta figure out where you wanna go with this. I know where I'm gonna go. I know where I'm gonna be, and what I'm doing is right. But do you really feel like you're doing this? You're doing right? Do you feel that way?
Are you serious right now?
I'm serious. I'm very serious. I'm so serious that I just. I don't even know. I don't even feel like eating right now. That's how serious I am. I don't even feel like cooking. I don't even feel like eating. I really don't even want to see you right now.
What?
Yeah. I'm tired of it.
Oh. I can't believe this.
You know what? You might want to go ahead and step.
Lawrence, no.
Nah, seriously, you ain't going to step.
Listen, I never...
Nah, I'm I lost my appetite and even cook for you. You know what? You need to go step.
Oh, wow.
I'm tired of it. I don't know. I don't think you value this relationship anymore. I think you value your job and your career. I don't think you value me anymore.
Lawrence, yeah.
You need to go think about some things.
I think you're right.
Yeah, I think so too.
I had no idea you felt this way.
Anybody who feels that way, if you never show that person you're in a relationship with, they have the same respect. When last time we did something other than something money related?
Lawrence.
No, huh?
I can't do this. I'm sorry.
Don't worry about me. I'll be fine. You have a nice night.
Feeling women are the new men. We are forced to be head of our households. We are forced to have competitive jobs to support the households. The men are kind of missing in our communities, and I'm referring to the African-American
community. You remember that Italian restaurant that we get those guys a month ago with some cocaine and stuff there?
That what restaurant?
The Fucino restaurant.
Where's it at?
It's 42 Street on the corner with Jefferson. So I took my girlfriend last night there. So you know what? My woman are crazy, definitely. She proposed me to get married.
Get the fuck out of here. Are you serious?
Yeah.
She asked you to get married.
You know Kelly.
Yeah.
You know her.
Yeah.
So she's a she's a good girl or whatever. And yeah. I say, come on.
What'd you say?
I say no.
You told Kelly no.
I said no. So when I say no, she say, I don't know. She was kind of freaky out about the situation.
She should be freaking out. Shit. Kelly's a good girl, man.
What kind of radio always listen? You change, just put some music there.
I don't know what you're babbling about, but you told Kelly no. That's bullshit, brother. Kelly's a good girl, man.
I know that.
I mean, damn, you know, if a woman cooks for you, cleans for you, man, doesn't nag you to fucking death, shit, that's a winner in my book, man.
Like your wife.
How the hell, right, like my wife. Now, you take my wife.
Oh, yeah, because, you
she's,
know.
She's,
You know about that.
Well, I'm just telling you, man, I mean, you know, a woman is a part of your groundwork, man, you know? You got the woman, then you get the house, family, all of that shit is structured behind a good woman, man. You got a good woman behind you, family strong. You got one of those bitches, you know,
yeah,
I'm telling you.
Yeah,
you in for a long ass haul. Wake up ready to go to fucking work.
But you know what?
Go to sleep ready to get the fuck up in the morning, man. You get the hell out of there, I'm telling you.
Yeah, but I know.
Think about your last girlfriend. What was the girl before Kelly? Rachel or some shit. Remember that?
Okay, then.
Now, she was fucking nuts.
Oh, yeah, man. All the women are fucking nuts. Come on, man. Come on. So anyway,
Kelly ain't nuts,
so
though,
I mean, just I mean, I don't talking about that all the women are fucking nuts, but you know, it's always something. So, I mean, I love Kelly, and we're gonna talk about that. I mean, listen, I don't want to talk about that shit anymore, you know. So.
Well, I think you should reevaluate your relationship skills, man. Get a book or something, man.
So huh? Nothing. You mentioned the other day when you called me that it's close to your. Is it birthday party or something or your? Family, your kids, or
yeah? Fuck yeah, man. I gotta call Aisha. I forgot about that shit. It's a fucking job, man. I love it, but it ain't got a lot of space for family. You know that shit.
Car today, man. Oof.
Hey.
Hey, Daddy.
I wanted to give you a call. You know, I've been working, honey, so I didn't forget about you, but Daddy's just been busy, so I wanted to take a few minutes to give you a call.
Oh, it's okay, thank you. I know you've been busy. It's okay, I know you got a lot going on.
I'll be home here in about a day or so.
Okay.
Okay, I love you.
I love you too.
All right, bye-bye.
Now, are you hungry?
Nah, man, I'm not that hungry.
You know, you're not gonna hot dog something just to change, you know, your stomach?
I'll tell you what I'm hungry for, man. I'm hungry for some change. You know, we've been doing this shit, man, for, you know, 15 years.
I know.
I mean, I love the job, man.
Still remember the day when we sweating with the flock? We were just a kid.
I do.
Say, I swear. Come on, look at this. We've been through a lot of stuff, man.
You remember down in, when we did the Mexico gig?
The what?
The Mexico gig down there, man. Remember that?
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Well, what? You know when we took those guys down, man, and just for that damn second, when you saved my ass in the back on that patio?
Yeah.
Fucking guy jumped me?
Yeah.
I thought I was dead, man.
Yeah, it was kind of, you know, it was a difficult moment.
No, I thought I was dead.
You were dead? What are you talking about?
I'm talking about for that moment, brother. What the fuck I was going to do tomorrow didn't matter, man. So it got me thinking. You know?
So, but we're still here alive and everything is okay.
That's right, and I want to keep it that way, man. I want to make some changes.
Yeah. Me too.
Do some things different, man.
I'm starting to think about what Kelly proposed me, but I can think about now that get married.
You need to marry that girl.
And you know.
Go for it now, yes, man. Go for it now.
But it's not easy, you know.
There ain't nothing easy.
You have a lot of arrangement to do. You know, going to the church, get some stuff, and then, I don't know. So listen. What were we doing here? I thought you were going to get some vacation or something. Okay, what were we doing here?
Well, just, I mean, I did say vacation, but I ain't say like the beach or the mountains or something, brother. It's a getaway. So getaway for change, man. And change is going to start today. Today.
Are you waiting for something or what? I mean,
Something.
What is the
deal? Waiting on something, brother. Something that should have been happening a long time ago.
Something going on that you don't want to tell me about it? This is what you're waiting for?
Yeah, hold on. I got it, bro. Let me take care of it. All right, just hold tight.
Hello?
Maurice, talk to you. You're getting tall, son. Well, like your granddaddy, remember, was 6'2"? I remember we was playing in the backyard back when you was about 4.
I don't hear anything you're telling me right now, because it's nothing but gibberish. One thing I do know is that you're trespassing. Your car should be on the outside of this property because you don't have no rights here. So I think you need to just back up, you know what I'm saying? And you can talk to me from over the fence, you know what I mean? Because you shouldn't be in vicinity of me right now. Like, seriously.
Hands on your hips. You're so tall, I couldn't see you over the fence. I don't want to see you.
Move your car off my property?
Maurice, I drove 500 miles.
I don't care if you drove 1,000 miles. Get off my property, park your car, and we can talk over the fence.
We don't need to talk over the fence.
Okay, we're right. We don't need to talk at all. So, can you?
We don't need to talk over the fence.
Okay, we don't need to talk at all. You're making me repeat myself. I don't like repeating myself.
I don't like hearing the same stuff.
Look, man, then just go back.
Well, Marie.
Wait, you said 500 miles? Can you go back 500 miles? You know what I'm saying? We don't have to have this conversation. It's been 15 years, sir. 15 years. And you're just going to clap yourself, come out of nowhere? To say what?
I've been with you every day.
No, you've been where?
I've been with you every
been
day.
Been where?
I've been with
you
every day.
You have not
son.
Been anywhere.
You're right. There's a couple things you're wrong about.
No, you know what's wrong? What's wrong is you leaving my mother. That's what's wrong. What's wrong is you're not showing up to my high school, you know what I'm saying, graduation. That's what's wrong. Not showing up to my college graduation 2 weeks ago. That's the problem. And then you still got your car sitting here, parked here, you know what I'm saying, trespassing. That's what's wrong. So I asked you one last time to move your car out in the street. Where it belongs. Where you belong.
I'm gonna move the car out in the street in a few seconds.
No, you're gonna do it now.
I didn't leave your mama. I didn't leave you.
Dude, I don't wanna hear this, man. Like, seriously, what is your point of coming up here to tell me this? You know what I'm saying? For what? I'm not listening to you. Whatever you say is going in one ear and out the
other. Son, you can ignore me.
I don't got nothing to say.
You can get mad at me. You can hate my guts. But I can guarantee you one thing. Wherever you go from this day forward and wherever you've been from this day backwards, you a part of me. You a part of me. And when I'm dead and gone, you still gonna be a part
man,
of me.
Man, you dead and gone, I don't got no ties to you. I don't got no ties to you now.
You always gonna have ties.
Whatever, man.
Just like the anger you feeling right now?
Nah, man.
You think that's coming out of nowhere? You think the feelings come out of nowhere?
No. That's my colleague, man. I don't got nothing to say to you, man.
Everything all right, man?
Yeah, everything's all right, man.
All right, man.
I'll be in a few minutes.
All right, cool.
All right.
So look, son, I got one thing to say. And if you don't want to deal with me after that, I'll never come back again. But I want you to know that I'm sorry.
I've heard that before, man.
And I love you.
Yeah, whatever.
And I'm leaving the force. 15 years too late. It's done. I just want to do things different. I want to do things different with you. I can't make up for the past. All I can do is work on the now. And I'm not expecting you to forgive me instantly. Hell, even like me instantly. Give me a shot. Because aside from the day, every time I close my eyes to go to sleep, son, you're still that 3-year-old. Used to play out in the backyard, you know. That's where I'm at.
What's going to be different? I mean, I've heard promises before, man. And, I mean, tell me all this to say what? I mean, Mom's always told me, you know what I'm saying, I love you. And she showed me, you know what I'm saying? Like, she's always told me, you know, actions speak louder than words. So, I mean, we both know that when you finish here, you're going back home, you know what I'm saying? You're going back to D.C. or wherever you came from. You know what I mean? So you telling me all this gibberish for what? You know what I'm saying? Well, things going to change. What's going to change? You know what I'm saying? Like,
hey, Tony, I really... Oh. Oh, no, it's me. Hey, Kelly. No, I thought... Yeah, I know that I've been rude and asked school last night, but... you know what? I was thinking about it, and... I really love you. I mean... I wanna do marry you. Yeah. Listen, I'm very happy with you, and we're gonna get it. We're gonna do it, and we're gonna be happy. So, what? I changed my mind.
You told Kelly no. That's bullshit, brother. Yeah, Kelly's sorry. A good girl, man.
I know that.
I mean, damn, you know, if a woman cooks for you, cleans for you, man, doesn't nag you to fucking death, shit, that's a winner in my book, man.
My mind changed because,
I'm tired of empty promises, for real, you know what I'm saying, like.
I missed out on everything with you. Because I made piss poor decisions 15 years ago. You give me a shot, son, I won't fuck it up. That's man to man. I want to be in your life. So I love you and I'm sorry, Maurice. And let me show you. Better than I can tell you.
It was
funny, like, 15 years. I lay up in my bed, contemplating, like, the day, if you would ever show up, you know what I'm saying? And I kept wondering, like, what I was gonna do, like, if I was gonna charge you, hit you, if I was just gonna simply walk away. And I never came to full conclusion on what I would do today if you were to show up. It's funny how things just miraculously happen, you know what I'm saying? And you just show up unannounced today. 2 weeks after my college graduation. And so I'm standing here thinking, how do we conclude this? You know what I'm saying? Like, you're telling me all this stuff that's gonna happen in the future, but we can't see the future, you know what I mean? I look at now, take day by day.
That's the only way we can take.
So my question is, where do we go from here?
And you reach your breaking point, and you just gotta be like, it's over.
You said you'd never leave me. I swore I'd never.